Well, there are a few words to describe young adults who still live with their parents. Some call them kidults, like kids and adults. Those who fail to make the transition into adulthood. Others call them kippers, kids in parents' pockets eroding retirement savings.
Right, whatever you call them, there are many around us. 29%, in fact, of 18 to 34-year-olds have never left the family home. And as you're about to see, some young adults are moving backwards.
There's no place like home.
Those five magical words transported Dorothy back to the safety and comfort of Auntie M and Uncle Henry. But it's no fairy tale for many young Australians. Home is where the heart is. In fact, 29% of 18 to 34-year-olds are still living at home. In 2011, only 42% of young adults were living with a partner, and only half of those couples had children. But if we travel back to 1976, we see a surprising trend. 65% of young adults lived with a partner, and 75% of them had children. So, what's keeping the young adults of today from moving out? Is it study? It could be. Maybe they're too busy focusing on a career. Perhaps not. But with even the Prime Minister's daughters planning to stay at home until they get married, perhaps it's just out of family love.
Well, if I could move into the big house, I'd be staying there
too. They'd have nice rooms too, I reckon.
Yeah, good view. What's not to love? So, staff? Social analyst and demographer Mark McCrindle is here to shed some light on why many young adults choose to live with mum and dad. Good morning to you, Mark.
Hello, Mark.
I mean, let's compare it to the 70s. More young adults are still living, you know, with mum and dad. Why? Does it surprise you?
No, I mean, it's a trend that's been on for some time now. The traditional markers of adulthood and independence used to be marriage, mortgage, having children, career. That's all been pushed back significantly. And even the term young adult now officially describes someone 18 through to 34 years of age.
So, oh, really?
So, you're still a young adult even as you're hitting the mid-30s.
We compared the stats on that on study and work for young adults living in 1976 and 2011. Talk us through the results here.
Well, we've clearly got young people being in the education system a lot later. Now, you go back to the mid-1970s, only 5% of people in the late 20s had a university degree. Today, it's 40%. So they're in study longer, therefore they're delaying full-time earnings later. A lot of young adults are still working, but mainly part-time, so that's not enough to launch their own financial independence.
OK, I'm about to ask you what's keeping them from leaving. I would imagine housing affordability. Is that it?
It is. That is one of the big ones. I mean, just as we saw there, certainly studying longer and therefore delaying the careers, they are the top two. But you've also got just starting the family a lot later. It used to be an early 20-something phenomenon. People would get married and have kids in their early 20s. Mm. Now it's not till the early 30s on average in Australia.
So they're not feeling that need to move out because there's nothing to move out.
They're a solo unit, so they can stay with mum and dad. And housing affordability is massive.
It's got to be that.
Yeah, it used to be the average house in a capital city used to be 5 times the average annual earnings. Today it's 10 times average annual earnings. So it's twice as expensive.
And the schnitzels are better at home.
They are.
Generally speaking, is the parents who want the kids to sort of stay, or is it the kids who don't want to leave, or what's the mix on this?
Well, look, the kids certainly like it. I mean, what's not to like about free accommodation, free food and free mum and dad car? But beyond that, the parents, they do complain a little bit, but we have found that they do like it. The parents themselves are younger, longer in life. They're not ready to become empty nesters. They like having the kids around. It keeps them in touch with, you know, the younger generation. So I think they're happy.
And there are different cultures now that actually, you know, really work on that, right? Keeping the family all together for as long as possible.
Well, that's right. You know, in a sense, Australia is moving to what much of the world does, where, you know, the family unit, the multi-generational household, you're there forever. But it's a bit of a return to the past in our culture.
Okay. So what's the trend? Do you like looking at trends? If we look at the figures here, this is going to continue, right? We don't see any sort of vast change looming.
No, well, that's right. The house costs continue to rise.
Yeah.
Education is important, so young people are still going to delay their earnings. They want the flexibility of being able to live at home and then travel or volunteer, do other things, move jobs. So there's that security in the home base. So I think it's with us for a while. I don't think it'll continue to go later and later in life. I think it'll settle around the late 20s, early 30s today, but it's here to stay.
Mark, thank you very much. Now go home and clean up your room.
I will.
Thank you.